come to the question number 2. Question number 2 is very important. Okay, so question number 2 actually you can solve in different ways. So ABCD is a rhombus and PQRS are the midpoints of the sides AB, BC, CD and D respectively, so that the quadrilateral PQRS is a rectangle. So question number 2, at first it is given that ABCD is a rhombus. Okay, so rhombus means all the sides are equal. Suppose this one is ABCD, A, B, CD is a rhombus. Okay, so PQRS are the midpoint. So this one is suppose like this, P, Q, R and S. When that ABCD is a rhombus, okay, ABCD is a rhombus and P, Q, R, S are the midpoints of the sides. P is the midpoint of the side AB, Q is the midpoint of the side BC. Again, R is the midpoint of the side CD and S is the midpoint of the side DA. We have to prove that P, Q, R, S is a rectangle. So at first, all of you know, I think, a parallelogram whose one angle is 90 degree, which will be a rectangle. Already there is an example in I think 8.1. okay, so if you prove that PQRS is a parallelogram and after that if you prove one angle is 90 degree, then it will become a rectangle. So now you just draw two diagonals. Okay, that two diagonals intersect at the point O. So let ABC, given ABCD is a rhombus where P, Q, R and S are the midpoints of the sides AB, BC, CD and DA respectively. Okay, so we have to prove that, or we have to show that PQRS is a rectangle. Okay, so this thing we have to write. Again, you just write here diagonals. Here, just write here let diagonals AC and BD intersect at O. Okay, so just draw this AC and BD diagonals intersect at the point O. So at first we will prove PQRS is a rectangle. PQRS is a parallelogram, which one is very easy. After it will prove one angle of that parallelogram is 90 degree, then automatically it will form, it will be a rectangle. Okay, so proof. So like the previous one, in triangle ADC, this triangle ADC, S and R are the midpoints of the sides A, AD and CD respectively. Okay, ABCD, yes, respectively. So we have a midpoint theorem. Of triangle get SR is parallel to AC, and what is SR is equal to half of AC, which is number 1. Okay, so SR is parallel to AC and SR is equal to half of AC, which is number 1. Okay, now similarly just write in a triangle ABC, again in triangle ABC, P and Q are the midpoints of the sides AB and BC respectively. Okay. So therefore, by midpoint theorem. Of triangle we get, so similarly we'll get PQ is parallel to AC and PQ is equal to half of AC, which is number 2. So according to 1, SR is parallel to AC and SR is half of AC. From 2, PQ is parallel to AC and PQ is half of AC. That means from 1 and 2 we'll get PQ is parallel to SR and PQ is equal to SR. Okay. So now from equations 1 and 2 we get PQ parallel to SR and PQ equal to SR, so therefore PQRS is a parallelogram. Okay, so first thing here complete, that means PQRS is a parallelogram. If you prove any one angle of that parallelogram is 90 degrees, then automatically PQRS become a rectangle. Okay, so for this you have just give two name of two points. Okay, suppose if this point is M and this point is N. Okay, just give this point M and this point N. So now since PQRS is a parallelogram and we know that the opposite pairs of parallelogram are parallel, so that means SR is parallel to PQ. If SR is parallel to PQ, then MR is parallel to, I'm not going to write this one. If SR, already we know that SR is parallel to AC. If SR is parallel to AC, then MR is parallel to ON, because MR is the part of SR and ON is the part of AC. Okay, so now since SR parallel AC, so that implies MR parallel ON. Okay, so this line is parallel to this. Yeah, this one is parallel to this one. So similarly, so you just give the point number 3 here. Again, look at this one. R is the midpoint of CD and Q is the midpoint of BC. That means RQ is parallel to DB. RQ is parallel to BD. Okay. So again, you can write directly RQ is parallel to BD by midpoint theorem. No need to write again the whole thing that R is the midpoint of Q, CD again Q is the midpoint of. Directly you can write that RQ is parallel to BD by midpoint theorem. If RQ is parallel to BD, then RN that implies R M must be parallel to OM or M MO. Number four. So from 3 and 4, you'll get MR is parallel to OM and RN is parallel to MO. That means MONR is a parallelogram. So now from 3 and 4, we get MONR. MONR is a parallelogram. Okay, but all of you know that the diagonals of a rhombus are actually bisect at right angles. That means this AC is a diagonal and BD is a diagonal. They bisect each other at 90 degrees. That means this angle will be 90 degrees. And already we proved that MONR is a parallelogram. And we know that the opposite angles of parallelograms are equal, so that means this will be also 90 degrees. And if R angle is 90 degrees, then PQRS becomes a rectangle. So you just write here again diagonals of a rhombus. Diagonals of a rhombus bisect at right angles. Bisect at right angles. Okay. So therefore, angle M O N equal to 90 degree. Okay, you can write angle, actually angle D O C equal to 90 degree. After that, you just write. So therefore, angle D O C equal to 90 degree. So that implies angle M O N equal to 90 degree. Okay, if M O N equal to 90 degree, so therefore, but opposite angles of parallelogram are equal. So therefore angle MRN is also 90 degree. Okay, so that implies angle SRQ equal to 90 degree. So therefore PQRS is a rectangle. Okay, so in this way you can prove this one. Again, another method you can also prove this one. Okay.